And welcome back. This is your RPG check. We're outside Durgan's battery. You've pretty much defeated everything. You can stop with the suspenseful music. I'm gonna try a few things, so I'm going to cut to whatever works. Gonna try inside the battery first. If you don't see me, oh, I can go in. Oh, that's right, I've been in there. Never mind. I have to go back in this way. Alright. See you guys when we get somewhere. Okay. I noticed on my playthrough I missed this. And I'm not sure if there's another door along here. But we have a guard's key. We can use it to unlock this, so. See what goodies we might find.
He'll regret this.
Trap. Nothing to say about that trap. Do not remove any equipment from this armory without permission from Arms Warden Maroon or Captain Gregor. A battered helm. Could this be the rest of that helm? The surface of this ancient helmet is pitted all over with dents like pock marks on a diseased scalp. Two crusty sockets at the front mark the absence of what would likely have been horns. Alright, because we got the horns, right. Hello? As it has twice before, your vision blurs and fades to black. When it returns, you find yourself on your knees, a shattered sword in your hand, and a broken, battered helm in front of you. Your helm. You can feel blood pouring down one side of your face, and you know for certain that you will never see out of your left eye again. Arrayed around you in a circle are other warriors, some from your tribe, the rest from an enemy tribe. They watch the combat in silence. You're going to die, old man. Your opponent is brash, but young and strong. You still think single combat was a good idea? You do. Last winter's famine took a heavy toll on your tribe, and your warriors were in no shape to fend off an all-out attack from its enemies. Single combat was your tribe's only hope, but not if you lose. Once again, the world stops. The memories trail, awaiting your guidance. Take him down with you, I guess. You force yourself to your feet and toss away your broken blade. Summoning the last reserves of your energy, you charge your opponent. He's ready for you. His blade bites deep into your side. A mortal blow. He laughs, but the last laugh is yours. You are older and you are slower, but you're still strong. You seize the young warrior's head and with a roar of triumph, snap his neck and drop his corpse into the mud. Wow. You remain standing, sheer willpower keeping you up, until you are certain that you are the undisputed winner of the combat. It is not until the last of the enemy warriors have left your village that you allow yourself to collapse. The last thing you ever remember is the hands of your people reaching out to catch you. Yes. Yes, it's all coming back. My sister. My reign. The end. Oh! Garodh looks at his own spectral form with a sad surprise in his eyes, watching it begin to fade. But I've only just seen it. There's been so little time to know what to make of it all. Am I going to get anything out of this? Oh, farewell, Garodh. The wheel has no patience, it seems. I entrust my helm to your care. You find Garad's helm in your hands, whole and unbroken. Farewell, my friend. He says. We've got a Garodh's chorus. I recovered all the parts of Garodh's chorus and reforged the helm. I reforged it? When the hell did I do that? Oh yeah, what's going on with this? I forgot about that. I'll look at that in a second. Plus 3 might or retaliate when hit by a melee attack. This helm once belonged to Garodh, a long-dead tribal chieftain. For some reason, his soul never returned to the wheel, lingering until he had forgotten much of his own history. Fortunately, you came along and helped him remember. These cloaks of protection are really good, though. I don't know. You know, I'll try it for Palagina. Look at all these things that... Oh. Cannot occupy that slot. What does it occupy? Oh, that helm! I always get that missed up. She can't wear anything on her head, right? Because she's a godlike thing. Okay. Never mind. I might just give it to her, Devil of Carrick. Well, this is a regular helm. Okay. Might. That's might plus 3. Okay. I'm going to give this to Adair. Who has it? Palagina now? Or I can put it back? Oh. Cool, look at him. He's a Viking lad. Alright, what else we got in here? We're sneaking, so we...
Margaret's fire casts light in dark places.
So we find secrets. Unlock with guard's key this too. Nothing happened at first. Durgan iron ingot and camping supplies. Hooray. Now what's funny is that on my way... Oh, you can't see it, but on my way back here from where I started the episode off, we were attacked by more Lagophoth and ice spiky things, whatever the hell they're called.
What?
No. Not yet. Breastplate, girdle of the driving wave, and a crested hat. Grants knockdown. I think we already have one of these just sitting around. Yeah, I'm not gonna... I'm gonna keep that.
You
okay.
Can trust me.
Alright, we're gonna trip the trap. Actually, here. Yeah, you know what? He went up in levels, but I don't think I added anything to his mechanics.
What?
Wheel.
The wheel. What's in here? Fine rapier. and Bad Gratter's barricade. We don't find special shields that often. One-handed, medium shield, 12 deflection, minus 4 accuracy, grants bash. ...10% of ranged attacks reflected back at attacker, grants thrust of tattered veils on critical hit. Which is 18 to 35 cross versus deflection. This heater shield bears the Black Wolf of the Bad Gratter line, as well as the personal sigil of the shield's last bearer, Mechgrun Bad Gratter. These are awfully awkward names. A renowned fighter, Mechgrun had a reputation for practicality and ingenuity, and in his hands his shield was much a weapon as his blade. Mechgrun had a particular fondness for taking on spellcasters, for his shield could reflect his foe's own arrows or spells against them, and a blow to the face from the barricade was usually enough to put an end to further casting. While their ungratter cousins went on to rule the Cold Water region, the Bad Gratters did not survive the War of Defiance. Mechgrun himself perished in the Battle of Defiance Bay, and his shield passed into the hands of a series of noble masters before slipping from common recollection. Anyone? Yeah, she's using a shield. She's using a supper plate. Here. Let's compare. Where is it? Now we've got exceptional on that one, too. Where is it? Yeah, I'm gonna give her that one. Kinda weird for a rogue to have a shield, I guess, but I don't know. Pretty awesome looking though, isn't it? I like that. Very colorful. Okay, what about this resonance thing? I forgot all about that. Tasks. I don't know what he wants us to do. I don't see that quest. Oh, she can level up. I love Carrick. Let's add 2 athletics. save the rest. Crippling strike. The rogue attacks his or her enemy's ability to move around effectively, inflicting extra damage to and hobbling any enemy successfully hit. That's pretty cool. Escape. Allows the rogue to break engagement expertly, avoid the next attack, diving out of range to a specific location. That's pretty cool. You really see that shield. Pretty awesome. I like the escape one. Riposte. Incoming melee attacks that target deflection and miss have a chance of allowing an instant full attack. I guess she gets an attack back, I don't know. The rogue becomes especially skillful. Converts graze to misses, okay. Fearsome strike. What's the difference between this and crippling strike? Two per encounter or one per rest. Hobbled for 11.5 seconds. Or hobbled and weakened for 11.5 seconds. Smoke cloud. The rogue creates a small cloud of smoke that leaves adjacent enemies distracted for a short duration. The rogue performs a primary attack that does additional damage and can leave the target stunned. Two per encounter. Let's take that. Two per encounter, I like that. It's for a short time, but why not? And I need to go over there. Alright, let's see what we got. That's it. Okay, well at least we finished that. What about this thing again?
Yeah.
I don't know what the hell that does for us.
Quickly and quietly.
No. I don't know if we're gonna get into another combat.
Sure.
But what we'd want to do is go back downstairs. No! Oh, I meant to choose the next guy.
Well, this is testing my endurance.
Alright, let's use our...
Sure.
Whatever. Alright, let's go. I want to see if we can figure anything else out downstairs. Oh, now we can talk to it. Supposedly.
Stop, Marauder! Our bodies are dust already. Must you profane holy ground with further violence?
Flames roar and whip from within the forge. As they rise, their glow washes the room in a gory crimson light. Now, you saw before, guys, I was clicking on that and... Or we were like, we were said we were drawn to it or something. And now that we come back, we get a little talk icon thing.
Did the height of our walls offend you? Did we cross your borders? Sail you weak steel?
No, to all the above.
Tell us,
Why did you invade our fortress?
Behind the anger and through the roaring flames, you hear the voice of a tired old man. I think there's a misunderstanding. This place is abandoned.
No, that cannot be. Abidan wouldn't allow it.
The flames flicker and shudder, and the stones beneath your feet grow suddenly cold. Well, we're either going to fight them again, or they're going to realize it.
Wake up, Exandru! This is why Abidan gave us the White Forge, that we might take up arms and deal with villains like this.
Heat surges once again from the forge, prickling your skin.
Such a magnificent device, and she can only see it as a tool for war. She shames our grandparents, who wandered this continent. Quiet, both of you! Can't you feel it? This chill. This silence.
The fires crackle and snap. Yes, please realize it. I don't want to fight you guys again.
But you... you entered our keep and found it abandoned. Ruined. What happened to us?
His question drifts from the mouth of the White Forge, wreathing you like a cloud of smoke. I could do either of these, of course, but I want to see what they remember here. I was hoping you could tell me. What do you remember?
It was strange. They came so suddenly.
Yeah, who came?
I'd never seen anything like them. Twice the size of any ogre, and positively fearless. They were...
eyeless. Yet no matter how hard we fought, or how deep we hid, they kept coming for us.
Eyeless? What were they?
Some kind of magfolk, but bigger than any we knew of. We who survived never got close.
They were relentless. Unnaturally so.
Why did they attack you? They didn't stop to explain themselves, yet I wondered at what monstrous wilder might survive. In a place like this.
We should have taken our steel and pushed east.
What's to say they didn't come from the east? From the lands Maroon so coveted? It was a punishment for taking this gift of Abidan, the White Forge, and squandering it on our greed and vanity.
The other voices say nothing, but you feel their doubt and dissent in the stifling heat of the forge. Go on.
We retreated until there was no place left to go. Until those of us who remained were here.
Here, with the salvation Abidan had left us.
You used the White Forge to channel your souls into the battery.
Yes. Using the same methods with which we had fashioned so much cold steel. It was agony. Feeling your soul ripped from your flesh. Feeling every part of you torn asunder. But it saved us.
Imprisoned us.
It was Abidun's grace. Now, we inhabit the monument our people built to the White Forge.
What does this have to do with Abidan?
The White Forge belongs to Abidan, of course. It is here that he built his own body.
Say what? He built his own body?
And whether he found this place or created it, it's a truly remarkable smithy. We Pargrunin are wanderers by nature. But it was Abidan's call that led our forefathers here, after generations spent along the Pearl Coast and Air Glonfoth.
So the old stories say. Then again, I can't see any other reason our grandfathers would have stayed here when greener lands lay east.
How does the White Forge work?
Its fires have been blessed by Abidum. They're fed by Aora's molten heartbeat and veined with Audra that runs to the center of the world.
Which explains their conductive power. See, these Audra veins allowed us to siphon essence into steel as we shaped it.
And that essence, the extraordinary heat of the forge, and our smith's skill is what made Durgan's steel so remarkable.
I see. And now you're here, in Durgan's battery.
Stuck here, you mean. With all the others who sought to escape the Eyeless.
Is that a bad thing? I think it is.
Had we thought longer on the fate that awaited us, we might have chosen a quick death to this slow agony.
Blasphemy! There's no greater honor than remaining here, watching over the White Forge.
Easily entertained, huh?
The long vigil is a quiet duty, but a noble one, nonetheless. I only wish we could protect this humble monument better.
Or do something. Anything. We were once among the greatest smiths in the known world. Tell me, do Kith still speak of us?
Do they? They speak of the White Forge. They don't speak of you, I don't think. This would be nice to them. Yes, and highly, you are still regarded as Master Smiths.
That is good to know. It's only a shame that this legacy is nothing but a memory.
The White Forge radiates gentle warmth.
Is this why you braved the restless souls of Durgan's battery? To recover the process of Durgan's steel?
I'm hunting a group called the Leaden Key, and they were seeking a way into the battery. At this admission, you feel a softening in the essence of the Pargrunin. In one moment, each soul and fragment is distinct, and in the next, they form an indistinguishable host. You perceive them as a school of fish caught in a tide, a flurry of snowflakes on the wind, a pantry full of fragrant spices.
Then I hope you're satisfied with what you found here.
Elf.
At least you get to leave this place.
But it was good to be remembered. However briefly.
As the souls of Durgan's battery speak to you, their collective essence takes shape, much like Meyerwald's did. There are scores of them, all torn by conflicting purposes and trapped in the memory of their lost battle. You taste the bitterness of their uncertain existence and feel the persistent ache of centuries. It is a slow, agonizing fate, but you find it in your power to grant them another. Oh, I can release them? Bind them to the cannons. I guess these blind things we might have to fight in part two? Unless they're gonna suddenly appear now. Let's not bind them. Let them choose. Maybe this guy, what's his name, will want to stay anyway. You're free to roam again. Return to the wheel and seek new lives. You perceive the tenuous connections between the souls and the battery. As you sever them, the souls cry out, some in relief and others in rage. Pressure builds in the ether, which swarms with essence and energy. You cover your ears and grit your teeth against the devastating hum that builds in the core of your soul. I guess they don't have a choice but to leave then, because some of them are crying out in rage. cool. And we got stuff here too. The White Forge is now available for your use. It has unique ability to refine Durgan iron ingots. Multiple iron ingots are required to create a single refined ingot. After refinement, these ingots can be used at any time in enchanting recipes to augment weapons, shields, and armor with Durgan steel. Been a while since we saw a tutorial message. Hums with power, warm to the touch now. Kinda, go on an adventure. Okay. I released the souls of Durgan's battery to return to the cycle of life and death. So how do I use it?
Yeah.
Do I grab an item and just... How do I do it? Maybe I just craft here, I don't know. White Forge. Not enough materials. Hey, I got a lot of that. Oh, refined. I have to refine them, okay. Where do we have it? How do I refine these? I can't move them out. What did the tutorial thing say?
Sure.
Oh no, I don't want to go. I don't want to go over there. Yeah. Back here. Get back here. What the hell are you doing? How do I refine the steel? Well, the iron. Do I put it on the table or something? I can't move it out of quests. And right clicking doesn't do anything. Or is this another bug where I'm supposed to be able to do something and the game won't let me? Oh wait, here we go. Okay, we have to click this, not that. Okay, so we've got some refined stuff here. plus 15% attack speed, plus 0.3 to crit damage multiplier, and 20% of plus 20% of hits converted to crits. That's pretty good. Blade of the Endless Paths. Nice. I guess I can't enchant a soulbound weapon. What happened? Wait a second. 10 out of 13. All I have to do is get 3 more. What about the greenstone staff? Oh, 2 more. Durance hardly ever uses a staff. Soulbound. Done. Can't do that. I'm guessing do forbidden, forgiven, unforgiven. I dub it unforgiven. I can add some more stuff here. Check this out. Cool. Make Durance's staff exceptional. And for slaying, I don't know, it doesn't really matter, he hardly ever uses it. Spirit? I don't wanna wait, I only got, yeah. Maybe I can enchant a shield. ...10% of ranged attacks reflected back at attacker. 15% of incoming hits converted to grazes. Minus 15% single weapon speed penalty. That's pretty cool. Yeah, I'll do that. Takes one. Her shield. Ditto. Nice. If I get another one, we can return back here. Okay. Alright, that was it. That was pretty awesome. Pretty much awesome. Yeah. Look at that thing. Look at that stuff under there. I just never even noticed that. Oh, it's not even something moving, it's just molten. I guess it's lava, yeah. Or Royals of Flame or something. Anyway, thanks for watching. See you next time when we take care of some other stuff. I don't know, I don't have quests. We don't have quests in here right now. Oh, it's here. The Gray Sleep, where we gotta figure out. Oh, that dragon. Maybe now that we've gained a level and we have cool upgraded weapons and stuff, we can do that. Craigholt. I think we'll handle that before we go to the dragon. And these... That's the end. And, yeah, I'm doing this dragon at the end of White March Part 2. And this one I'm not doing because it involves us killing a man we have no reason to kill. Grimda hates us and not giving Kit a knife. So that is that. I know we have something. We have the dragon, we have the Gray Sleeper. Oh, we have Zawa's quest, which I guess didn't show up. Yeah. Okay. Alright guys, thanks for watching. See you next time, and endure. In enduring, grow strong.